Hello, hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. In previous session we have discussed the architecture of small and large intestines. In this class we are going to discuss secretions of small and large intestines. So, let us start with the small intestine. So, see, especially small intestine produces the two types of secretions. In those, number one is the mucus, number two is the enzymes. Especially intestinal enzymes, small intestinal enzymes. So, we just see small intestine is started at duodenum, that enter into jejunum and ileum. This is the general structure of the small intestine. This part is called as duodenum and this one is called jejunum. Finally, this part is called as ileum. We know very well about this. Already we drawn too many times. So, let us see where actually small intestine produces the mucus and where enzymes are produced by the small intestine of the human digestive system. See, duodenum that contains one part that is called as a duct. The duct connect with the pancreas. And also connect with the gallbladder. And also liver. So, in the duodenum, of small intestine, at this place, it means from here to here, the duodenum part that contains a specialized glands that is called as a Brunner's glands. If you see this area, if you cut this area, it looks like this. This contains the internal lining. This internal lining contains the glands. Like this, these glands that secrete the some amount of mucus into the inside of duodenum. Inside of the duodenum that is called as a mucus glands, and this mucus which is produced into the duodenum. And these glands are called as Brunner's glands. So, along with these Brunner glands, some of the cells that also producing the some bicarbonates. Some bicarbonates. See, the Brunner glands that producing the mucus and also some of the cells lining the duodenum also producing the bicarbonates. These bicarbonates and the mucus, they mixed with the food particles and especially acid chyme. Actually, acid chyme that is present in the stomach of the digestive system. These acid chyme that mixed with the bicarbonates and also mucus. So, what these two items are causing changes in the food item? So, see, Brunner's glands produced mucus that protects the internal layer of the duodenum. Internal layer of duodenum. And also we have another item that is called as a bicarbonate. These bicarbonates are mixed with the acid chyme and neutralize the acid. Neutralize acids. So, neutralizing acids, then only the inner part of the duodenum is protected from the acid attack. So, the food get neutralized by the bicarbonates. At the same time, these acid chyme also mixed with the bile salts and also pancreatic juices in the stage of the duodenum, especially in this area, papillae of Vater. At the papilla of Vater, pancreatic juices that are mixing with the acid chyme, and at the same time bile juices also mixing with the acid chyme, and the more important thing is in duodenum, especially from here to here. From here to here, that means from the beginning of the small intestine, that is the duodenum part, and this duodenum part up to the papilla of Vater, that contains the Brunner's glands. These Brunner's glands produces the mucus, and also this area also produces the bicarbonates. Both are together along with the pancreatic juices and bile salts protects the inner layer of the small intestine, especially duodenum, and also neutralize the acid chyme into the natural. In this way, duodenum especially contains the Brunner's glands for the production of the mucus. Then coming to the rest of the small intestine, that is the jejunum and ileum, and also this part of the duodenum. So, this part of the duodenum, jejunum, ileum, throughout these areas, this contains the strips of lubricants. What are the strips of lubricants? How they will help for the production of the mucus and also produces the enzymes? We will see here. See, from here to here, the small intestine actually that contains the villi. I discussed in the last class, and also contains the microvilli. Then, where is crypts of lubricants are present? That is the question. See, if you cut this section, that is looks like this. Like this. So here actually see there are the villi. And again this villi contains the microvilli. There is no doubt. So here are the villi in between the villi, there is the internal fold of the small intestines. Internal folds of the small intestine, that internal folds are called as crypts of the tubercles. Internal folds are called as the crypts, and entire this structure is called as the crypts of tubercles. Entire this structure we are called as crypts of tubercles. If you see this area, crypts of tubercles, it will looks, I will explain here. If you see this area, the internal structure of crypts of tubercles looks like this, that contains the epithelial cells. This area that contains the epithelial layer. These are the epithelial layer, epithelial cells of the small intestine. This epithelial layer contains the another cells, that cells are called as goblet cells. That cells are called as goblet cells. These red indicators are the goblet cells. Along with the goblet cells, there are one more cells that are called as these block indicators called as enterokines. Enterokine cells. So, what is clear here is the crypts of tubercles that contains the cells called as goblet cells and enterokines on the surface of the epithelial cells. Epithelial cells. Let us see which type of cells producing the which type of secretions into the small intestine. See, goblet cells are producing the mucus. Goblet cells producing the mucus in both crypts of tubercles and also villi. Crypts of tubercles and also villi. See, the condition is, the situation is the this area, this type of arrangement, like epithelial cells, enterokines and goblet cells, which are present in both crypts of tubercles and also villi. The difference is, goblet cells are the cells, they producing the mucus, that mucus produced by the both tubercles and also villi. Whereas enterokines, actually see, enterokines are the cells. These cells actually producing the bicarbonates and also water. Producing bicarbonates and water. bicarbonate and water in the crypts of lubricants. These bicarbonates and water get go into this area, and these bicarbonates and water produced by the crypts of lubricants is absorbed by the villi of the small intestine. It is released by the crypts of lubricants, and the same bicarbonates and water is absorbed by the villi of the small intestine. This is the condition. At the same time, these villi that contains the areas and these epithelial cells producing the some enzymes, those include the sucrase, maltase, isomaltase, lactase, and dextrinase. At the same time, intestinal lipase and peptidase. What actually villi are producing? The enzymes, they include the peptidase. The peptidase is the enzyme that act on the peptides. Peptides nothing but proteins. Sucrase, maltase, isomaltase, lactase and dextrinase. These are the enzymes that act on the disaccharides of the carbohydrates. Dextrinase are the branch of carbohydrates. Whereas intestinal lipase is the enzyme. This enzyme act on the lipids, especially fats. In this way, the arrangement of the small intestine and how they are producing the mucus and also enzymes are discussed here. Okay, let us see simple. The Brunner's glands, which are present in the duodenum, that secretes the mucus into the duodenum. At the same time, they produce the bicarbonates. Bicarbonates, mucus along with the pancreatic juices and bile salts, the acid can get neutralized in the duodenum. Whereas in the small rest of the small intestines, that is a part of duodenum and also jejunum and ileum. In these areas that contains the villi and microvilli, and also in between the two villi there is a crypts. That crypts we are calling the crypts of lubricants. These crypts are essential for the production of the mucus and also production of the water and bicarbonates. At the same time, villi epithelial layer that contains the cells that produces the enzymes, they include the sucrase, maltase, isomaltase, lactase, dextrinase and intestinal lipase, finally peptidase. These are the enzymes which are essential for the breakdown of the proteins and also disaccharides, some of the branch of the carbohydrates, finally fats. In this way, small intestine get arranged into the human digestive system for the purpose of the secretion of mucus and some enzymes. Okay, see, Then coming to the large intestine. Actually, large intestine is a region where actually food, undigested food, that is the fecal matter, is arranged and stored. So, in large intestine, there is no enzymes produced, but in the large intestine, mucus get produced. Then what actually mucus is cause? See, the strips of lubricants which are present in the small intestine also similarly present in the large intestine. Similarly present in the large intestine. The difference for this arrangement of architecture of the small intestine, large intestine is only the presence and absence of the villi and microvilli. Villi and microvilli that are present in the small intestine, whereas villi, microvilli that are absent in the large intestine. So, here in small intestine only region epithelial layer of the small intestine producing the enzymes, the rest of the part producing the bicarbonates and water. So, due to the absence of the villi, the large intestine cannot producing any enzymes into the large intestine. So, instead of producing the mucus into the large intestine, that mucus is essential for the protection of the internal layer of the large intestine, protection purpose. Protection purpose, and also this mucus along with the some bicarbonates, these bicarbonates nullifies the acid production, nullifies the acid production of fecus, and also these mucus are essential for the addition of fecus matter. Actually, see, if large intestine cannot addition property, the fecal matter gets dispersed in the large intestine to the small intestine. That's why large intestine that producing the mucus material along with the bicarbonates, they nullifying the fecal acid production in the fecal matter, and also they act as the addition moieties for the arrangement and making the food fecal matter into the large intestine. So, in this way, small intestine, large intestine get arranged in the human digestive system and also producing the mucus and enzymes which are essential for the protection and also breakdown of, and also finally absorption of food items. So, I hope this class is very clear to understand. And if you understand very neatly and clearly, please do subscribe my channel.